Today, we'll examine three critical MRI artifacts impacting our interpretation of articular cartilage and subchondral bone plate imaging, T2 anisotropy, the magic angle effect, and chemical shift artifacts. Let's start with T2 anisotropy. As you know, cartilage isn't just a homogeneous substance, it's highly organized. The collagen within it has a specific structure, and this structure affects what we see on MRI. When we're looking at T2 weighted sequences, pay close attention to the deeper layers of cartilage. You'll often notice they appear dark or low signal. This isn't pathology, it's due to the vertical orientation of those collagen fibers. Moving on to our second artifact, the magic angle effect. When collagen fibrils are oriented at approximately 55 degrees to the main magnetic field, what we call B0, the signal intensity increases. Lastly, let's discuss chemical shift artifacts. These typically occur at the boundaries between different types of tissue. A common place we see this is at the interface between the fat-containing medullary cavity and the bone plate. Understanding these artifacts is crucial when determining the depth of cartilage lesions. The location of the subchondral bone plate is our key reference point here. But defining this bone plate on MRI can be tricky, and here's why: the anisotropic fibrous organization of articular cartilage makes it susceptible to both the magic angle phenomenon we discussed earlier and those chemical shift artifacts at the fat-bone interface. We might overestimate the thickness of the subchondral bone plate, which in turn leads us to overestimate the depth of a cartilage lesion. And the linear truncation artifact indicated by the orange arrows is also visible. Thank you for watching. If you found my video helpful, please remember to like it.